we are taking that money and putting it in productive sectors that are going to be very important in the creation of jobs.
But Mr. Hinga, yes. Let's be clear. You say a levy is a tax.
Yes.
Now, my own understanding, we've heard it from here, from various presenters, a task, if it is a housing tax, then everybody, respective of who they are, will be subject to that tax.
Correct.
To tax. But if it's a levy, then you can even be go on a voluntary basis. Those who want to, because there are people, for example, who are in their 60s going to retire, may have retired, and they are paying a housing tax. So they ask themselves, how will this benefit me? Because I'm just about to retire. But if it is a tax, and they, of course, they have to pay. And that is a punitive aspect that Eugene was talking about.
From the PS, I mean the CS's presentation is calling it an investment. An investment can be voluntary, and according to the priority of either that teacher, that lawyer, that doctor, that policeman. But what is oppressive about this is that you must pay it as an employer. You know, it's cutting both ways, including people losing their jobs because they can't sustain this.
Correct.
Yeah. Yeah. The CS didn't refer to it as an investment. He actually qualified it further and said that this is an investment, not a tax.
Yes.
Please help us understand.
Not a tax. Now you are contradicting your own senior colleague there.
I said I'll come and rectify that. Let me come at my term to try and rectify that.
Yeah, but as of now, we are hearing from Bwana Hinga that this is a tax.
This is a tax.
The CS actually called it an intervention. I heard you say it's an intervention. I knew it was a tax. Everybody knows it was a tax. When we dropped it as an issue of a saving, it was immediately commuted in your own parliament as a tax. So I don't know where that misunderstanding has come from the last day of this presentation.